Another article out of Infowars.com. Two-thirds of Americans support drones for homeland security missions. A new survey shows that two-thirds of Americans support the use of unmanned spy drones for, quote, homeland security missions, despite the fact that such missions will include identifying gun owners and tracking the location of individuals via their cell phones, according to government documents. The poll conducted by the Institute for Homeland Security, a research consortium led by RTI International, shows that 67% of Americans support the use of unmanned spy drones for, quote, homeland security missions, and that 63% support their use in fighting crime. So the question is, how many Americans would support the use of these domestic spy drones if they really knew what they were for? Not just as a precursor to raiding family farms for the dastardly crime of allowing some cows to wander onto their land, as we saw in North Dakota with the Brossard family back in 2011, but as CNET's Declan McCullough recently revealed from government documents, the DHS is now customizing Predator B drones, originally designated for overseas operations hunting terrorists, to, quote, carry out at-home surveillance tasks that have civil libertarians worried, identifying civilians carrying guns and tracking their cell phones. Homeland Security's specifications for its drones shall be, this is a quote, capable of identifying a standing human being at night as likely armed or not, meaning carrying a shotgun or rifle. And they also talk about intercepting the phone signals to get your precise location. So we've seen in other polls that a significant majority of Americans oppose using spy drones to issue speeding tickets, for example. And again, it just goes to show, if they really knew what these drones were being prepared for, identifying gun owners, tracking people via their cell phones, would two-thirds of the American people support it? Would police departments be getting millions of dollars in grants from the DHS to buy these spy drones? Again, we find that a lack of education on this issue is key in the feds being able to mislead Americans on the true agenda behind the rollout of domestic spy drones, as the FAA announced last year, 30,000 in US skies by 2020. And that will include, of course, insect-sized drones as well as the huge Predator B-style drones. Mike Adams out of Natural News reports, transhumanism debunked, why drinking the Kurzweil Kool-Aid will only make you dead, not immortal. And I talked about this last week on the Alex Jones Show. There's been a deluge of new interest in the predictions of futurist Ray Kurzweil in the aftermath of the Global Futures 2045 conference in New York last weekend, at which he spoke. Of course, we saw the big Drudge Banner headline last week about humans being able to upload their brains to computers by 2045. That's one of Kurzweil's predictions. But as I have emphasized, if you actually read Kurzweil's 1999 book, The Age of Spiritual Machines, and bear in mind that this guy is a respected futurist because almost every one of the predictions he made back in 99 came true over the next 10 years. He predicted the likes of Google Glass, the Kindle, the iPad, the iPhone, on-demand services like Netflix. Basically, every technological development occurred over the past 10, 15 years. Kurzweil predicted it, so that's why people are still listening to him. But there's a side to his brand of transhumanism that you're not being told, and that is that the technology that will allow people like Kurzweil to upload their brains to computers by 2045, dispense with their physical bodies, and basically become a kind of virtual reality avatar in a Matrix-style artificially generated reality, that will all be the sole domain of the elite. It's not going to be available to the masses, because their plans for the rest of us, and this is what Kurzweil basically outlines in his own book, he won't say it publicly, but if you read his book, it's in there. What we've got to look forward to in their vision of the future is not very tasteful for us, because in his book, Kurzweil actually quotes Ted Kaczynski and gives his prediction credence that within decades, humans, the general public, not the elite, who will get all the life extension technology, but the rest of us will become superfluous and will either be sterilized out of existence or simply slaughtered en masse. That's what the elite have in store for us as they go through their transhumanist revolution. So in this article, Mike Adams succinctly outlines why the notion, as the elite are pursuing it, of uploading your mind to a computer does not represent immortality. It merely represents creating a copy of your own brain. Your body will still die. Your soul will not be able to live on inside a computer, is the quote from the article. In this plan, there is no mechanism to transfer your consciousness to the machine. So even if all three of these technologies are adequately developed, they still don't provide a way to merge your mind with a machine. Nothing more than a computer simulation of your brain. So Adams concludes basically that this will be a copy, a simulation, it won't be the original, and that transhumanism is a death cult that bears a stunning resemblance to the Heaven's Gate cult from back in the 1990s. Because even if you're able to make a copy of your brain and upload it to a computer, your soul, your consciousness will leave this mortal coil. The cult of transhumanism is for the elite only, and even if you're a part of it, it represents a spiritual holocaust that I want nothing to do with, and I'm sure many other people feel the same.
The important thing about the Pro One filter today is that the material we use for removing fluoride and other heavy metals now will remove the latest form of fluoride called hydrofluorosilicic acid. There's no other fluoride reduction filter out there that will remove that type of fluoride. And it's extremely important because today we're hearing more and more cities are using that form of fluoride.
We've been having medication forced on us through the water system for quite a while. Most people don't realize it. Most people don't realize the negative effects of fluoride.
There's a wide range of health effects that are attributed to fluoride.
Bottom line, why should somebody get this new Pro One ProPure filter?
The reason to buy the Pro One, it's an all-in-one filter. It's convenient, easy to use. It doesn't require the add-on fluoride filter. And in addition, this filter removes the latest form of fluoride called hydrofluorosilicic acid.